Hey everyone, so today I'm going to be giving you my back to school quick little makeup tips and product recommendations. This is mostly geared towards people who are just starting to get into makeup and want a few tips on how to look just a little bit better, and you know, you're just kind of dabbling into makeup. And also for you guys who know a lot about makeup, this is just like my product recommendations to you. Maybe you want to try it out, I don't know. So let's start off with my first little tip, and it is all about concealer. And by the way, most of these products are from the drugstore. Try to keep it a little, you know, low-end budget so you don't have to go out there and like spend a fortune. So this is the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. This is my holy grail concealer. I love it so much. So obviously this is too light for my skin tone. I shouldn't be like dabbing this on pimples because that would just be so obvious. I like to put this in like a C motion underneath my eyes. I got this tip from Miss Glamorazzi, if you're recognizing it. So you go from your inner corner and you kind of just sweep it down and then you just blend it in, and I swear it just lights up your eyes. It makes you look so awake, and everybody knows when you're back to school, oh my gosh, you're just dead tired. You don't want to be there. But seriously, this little tip, it makes the world of a difference. And also, I just like concealing my under eyes in general. Usually I just take a concealer and I do it in a triangle motion and I blend it out with my beauty blender. I love my beauty blender. So anyways, that is my little tip for concealer. For those of you who do not like to put cakey, heavy coverage foundation on your face, like me, BB cream is your best friend. I love the Garnier BB cream, and this is for a combination to oily skin. I love it. It honestly feels like you're wearing nothing on your skin. I've ranted about this so much on my channel, it's ridiculous. So for those of you oily people out there, this is definitely a really good BB cream, because I know I've tried a lot that just make me so oily and disgusting. So definitely for oily skin, this is my number one. But if you have more drier skin, I would probably try other ones out. I can't really give you a good recommendation because obviously that is not my skin type. But Garnier BB cream for the oily girls, this is great. So again, I'm just speaking out to my oily people out there. Oil blotting sheets and powder, your BFFs. This is the Clean and Clear oil absorbing sheets. You just pat your face and you literally look like fresh and amazing, and the oil is basically gone. I love this. I carry this in my backpack. I just love it. And for powders, I really like the Maybelline Dream Wonder powder and the Rimmel Stay Matte. These are awesome powders and I highly recommend them. Another tip to mask away the tiredness and the zombie grossness is blush. I think this just like livens up your face so much. I really like the Maybelline Master Highlight Blush in Pink Rose. This is just a very, very classic, universally amazing color. It's a classic pink color. I would probably guarantee this looks good on almost everybody. If you would prefer a coral blush over a pink blush, then definitely a Milani Luminoso. Girl, this is amazing. I'm not even kidding you. Everybody on YouTube loves it, and it's for a good reason. Especially if you have a tan, it will make your face look amazing, glowy, and just beautiful. A lot of people say brows frame your face. It is 100% true in my opinion. Brows are so important. It's insane. I feel like if your brows are like off and you have like a full face of makeup, it just does not look right. I'm telling you, I think brows are one of the most important things you can focus on. I used to like filling mine in with a powder, but mine are just so thick that I kind of got over that, and I just think a gel is better for me. So I really like the Maybelline Great Lash Clear Mascara. This is just a clear one, and I also really like the Benefit Gimme Brow. There's nothing like this at the drugstore. It's a color gel, and it's just amazing. It makes your brows look so good. I don't know, my brows are so ungroomed right now, but you couldn't tell that from like right now. I mean, I feel like they look pretty decent, so I don't know. I really, really like this. I know it's not drugstore, and I know it's $22 for this little thing, but I'm telling you, it is 100% worth it. So I'm gonna be honest with you, I love eyeshadow. If you've been watching my channel, you know I love eyeshadow. But when it comes to school mornings and I'm in a rush, I just don't do it most of the time. But I never forget to put in a little inner corner highlight. I think it just makes you look so much more awake. I know that's kind of like a reoccurring theme here. I think during school, I just want to look awake. Even though I'm not, it's so important to me. So that's what I'm trying to convey to you guys. I don't know, because that's just what's important to me. So anyways, inner corner highlights, right? So I really like this L'Oreal Quad in Because I'm Worth It. If it wants to open for me, that'd be really nice. I really like this inner corner highlight right here. You can see it. It is beautiful. Oh my gosh, do you see that? That is just, oh, it's so stunning. Oh my gosh, the pigmentation is there. Oh my gosh, it is amazing. Can you see that? It's just so gorgeous. It's so reflective. Oh, I love this. And you don't have to buy this kit just for the inner corner shade. I love the shades in this anyways. I think it's just so gorgeous. But if you have just a second to do eyeshadow, pop that in your inner corner. You'll look so much more awake. But if you're willing to spend a little bit more money, I do recommend the Naked Basics. This is my all-time favorite inner corner shade right here. It's called Venus. Oh my gosh, I love Urban Decay shadows. Oh my gosh. That's what I have in my inner corner today. Oh, wow. I mean, they probably look pretty similar on camera, but that one is prettier in my opinion. And this palette is just hands down my holy grail palette. I just can't get enough of it. I go back to it constantly. And if you want a natural look, and if you're starting off with makeup and you want to get into higher end makeup and you just want a palette or whatever, this is totally the one. I can't get over how much I love this. So if I really need to fly out the door and I have two things to do, it would be concealer and mascara. Mascara is so essential to me. It's ridiculous. It didn't used to be. I used to hate mascara. I thought like my lashes were fine how they were. I mean, I guess they were, but mascara has changed my life, basically. I love the Maybelline The Rocket Volume Express mascara. I'm not gonna go out there and say everybody needs to have this mascara, everybody's gonna love it, because I feel like everybody's mascara preferences is different. It just depends how you want your lashes to look. I don't know, but personally, this does the trick for me. My last little tip is carry around lip balm in your backpack. Nobody likes dry, chapped lips. Nobody. I mean, it's not comfortable for you. Nobody wants to look at it. It's not cool. So I really like the EOS lip balms. I think they're great. I really, really like their new one. It's the one in coconut milk. Oh my god, I can't even get enough of this smell. It's more moisturizing in my opinion than the other ones, and I just, oh my gosh, it's amazing. It just smells like coconutty, summery goodness, and seriously, you guys need to get this EOS lip balm. So that's it for my back to school quick little makeup tips and product recommendations. I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, of course, give it a big thumbs up, and also comment down below if you want to see any other back to school videos. I know I'm a little late in the game, but I start early September, so for me, I'm kind of early in the game. But anyways, I really hope you guys like this video, and I will catch you guys next time. Bye guys!